Hello, students. Today we're going to talk about merchandising, and more specifically about merchandising accounts. In the chapters you have had prior to this one, you have talked about a service organization. However, this chapter introduces merchandising. A merchandising business is one that purchases a product for resale. Therefore, we need to add some accounts to the chart of accounts that we've been using in the past. So I'm going to introduce some new accounts. The first one is merchandise inventory. This account is an asset, and as an asset, it is increased with a debit and has a normal debit balance. The second one I'm going to show you is sales. This would be our revenue account for the merchandise that we're selling, and that is a revenue and has a credit balance and is increased with a credit. Also, we have cost of merchandise sold because we have to purchase the merchandise before we can sell it. Therefore, we have an expense account called cost of merchandise sold, which is has a debit balance and is increased with a debit. Then we have sales discounts and sales returns and allowances. These are contra revenue accounts because they are offsets against the sales account. And any contra account has the opposite entry as the account that it's contra to. So therefore, these two accounts are increased with debits and have normal debit balances. If we have a discount, that's when we offer a discount to a customer for paying early, then we will decrease our sales, but we're not going to do it directly. We're going to do it through this contra account. Also, we might have some returns that our customer makes, or we might give an allowance for some reason. And if this is done, we're going to reduce sales again, but not directly, but through the account, the contra account, sales returns and allowances. These two accounts will reduce sales down to net sales on the income statement for a merchandising company. Okay. Let me talk a little bit about the difference between a perpetual and a periodic inventory system. A perpetual inventory system, we're keeping a record of inventory at all times. So therefore, every transaction that we have that relates to inventory will actually go through the merchandise inventory account. We will increase it when we purchase inventory, we will decrease it when we sell inventory, and also when we sell inventory under a perpetual system, we will use this cost of merchandise sold account. Under a periodic system, we do not keep a record of inventory all during the year. And in fact, the balance in our inventory account is the balance at the beginning of the year. And in order to get a balance at the end of the year, we must take a physical count of the inventory and then put a value on it. And that is how we actually value our inventory at the end of the year. We do not have a cost of goods sold account under a periodic system because we're not keeping a record of all of those sales. That brings us down to the next account, which is purchases. Since we are not keeping a cost of merchandise sold account, and also we're not changing the inventory account, when we make purchases, the amounts will go into a purchases account, which is only used for a periodic system and is an expense account with a normal debit balance, and it is increased with a debit. Just like we have sales discounts, we have purchase discounts and purchase returns and allowances. But in this case, these are discounts that we as the customer of someone else are getting and returns that we might make. But under a periodic system, we're going to use the purchase returns and purchase discounts accounts. Now, these are contra expense accounts and they have normal credit balances. These accounts are not used under a perpetual system because under a perpetual system, all the purchases, returns, and anything actually go through the inventory account. So therefore, the purchase returns and allowance and purchase discounts accounts are not used under a perpetual system. Okay. The last one I have here is freight expense. Freight expense is used to record any transportation cost. It is an expense account, and it has a normal debit balance. Now, it is used if the seller actually pays the transportation cost. Then it goes into the expense account called freight expense. However, if the purchaser pays the transportation cost, it is included in with the cost of inventory, and it would go directly into the inventory account. These are some of the new accounts that you will have in this chapter, and hopefully this will help you to understand what type of account they are and whether you debit or credit them. If you have any questions, let me know.